Aloha and welcome. This is number 52 of Heavy Metal Meditations, our continuing Saturday night sound journey extravaganza. We're gonna play some metal and some bowls and some rap drums and some tinkly things and try to craft an amazing sound journey for you all. Glad you could join us. Whenever you join us, we are streaming and recording, and I'll have the recording up on YouTube in a week or so. And yeah, that's that. The important thing to know if you're new to this journey is that these are heavy, thus the name Heavy Metal Meditation. And they move a lot of energy, and sometimes that can bring things up for people who are traveling. It can shake loose emotions, it can shake loose toxins, because we are 70-some-odd% water, and water vibrates and moves with sound, the percussion of sound waves. So it's totally okay, whatever comes up, it's yours. Experience it. Push it away if that's where you're at, but the invitation is to experience it and decide if it's useful or not. And if it's not useful, during Kaimi's and I beginning spots, we'll be taking in 3 deep breaths. And while we do that, we grow roots. So the invitation is to grow some roots down in the Mama Gaia. That sets up energy pathways for you to let go of anything that you no longer need to bring up sustenance from Mama. And also makes for the what I like to call the mitochondrial effect, which is my roots are going down and spreading out, and I'm expecting they're probably going to touch into your roots and create a morphogenic field for transformation here. That's the story that I make up. We'll go for perhaps a little more than an hour. I've been hearing a call to do a little bit longer. So if anybody needs to leave at like 9:20, raise your hand. Nice. Okay, we'll go for a bit longer. And it'll be fun. Thank you, Kaimi. I heard the phone ring, and I'm like, who's that? so we'll do an hour. We'll play. We'll see you on the other side. If you have water, keep it by your side. Drink a little bit before we get started.
And I don't know if you said, you might want to set an intention for your journey. Did you say that?
I didn't. Okay. Thank you so much. And if you don't have an intention, set it for the highest good of all people on this planet. And you know, may as well just like expand that out and go every entity in the entire existence for our highest good. Because that's what we're all here for. Expand into our highest good. Yes? Okay. We breathe. We go. See you in an hour. Plus.
That's right.
Hi.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. this meditation journey draws to a close, the invitation is to find your breath. And allow that to draw you back into this present time, space, and your physical being. As part of that return, you may find that your fingers and toes would like to move a little bit. Thanks for the reminder, Tejas. So it's really important when following up with a gong journey, a meditation journey with a lot of deep, loud sounds, that you drink plenty of water for a few days, 2 or 3 days. It helps flush out any toxins that might get released, and it's just really a freaking amazingly good idea anyway. Certainly before you get behind the wheel of a car, drink some water to help ground and bring you back to the present. Maybe get your feet on the bare ground. That's also another really good idea to do anyway. Thank you for joining the live stream. We're going to let you go and finish up here. As always, mahalo, and keep your light shining during these interesting times. And we'll see you the next time you're looking at us. Actually, you'll see us the next time you're looking at us, because I can't see you. But I know you're there. Peace out.